Everyday life, from the significant to the petty. Time now for Christy Gustafson Barletti on 107.7 GNA.
So I had written earlier this week of basically saying, for years, I mean, always, I thought that essentially if you were in high school, you were too old, you needed to stay home. Then somebody posted something online this week and changed my perspective. And I started defending the teenage trick-or-treater.
What was said that totally changed your mind? Because that takes a lot, Christy.
It does. We did a segment like a month ago where I said no one ever changes my mind online, and then someone changed my mind. Essentially what happened was they basically posted something about how, like, let these kids be kids. You know, teenagers could be doing so much worse on Halloween night. Collecting candy is pretty interesting. They're not, interesting, innocent. They're not vandalizing. They're not doing drugs. They're not drinking and driving. They're just knocking on your door and asking for a five-cent piece of candy.
All fair points.
And I read that, and I thought, you know what? Like, I was really bitter toward them, and I'm going to soften this year and embrace all those teenagers listening and come to my house.
Oh, my goodness. Facebook changed someone's opinion on something.
And me, who's like
Oh, my goodness.
Tough one to change. But so that made us wonder, because a lot of people commented on that, and I would say the majority said, you know what, I think you're right, that's a good point. But some said, nope, keep the teenagers away, I still don't want them.
So here's my thing.
So that made us, go ahead.
This is my thing on Halloween, and it's been like this every year. So if you're a teenager and you come to my door and you're just with your friends and you're not really, you don't really give it an effort, so you're in a tracksuit and you're like, I'm warming up for, I'm a runner, like, right. Or just makes
I'm
up
on
something.
The cross country team.
Yeah, I'm on the cross country team. Or you're in sweats and have pantyhose over your head and you're like, I'm a robber. I don't accept that. I'm like, do better, come back, and I'll give you candy.
Wait, you don't even accept the pantyhose over your head?
No, I think that's a cop. Well, maybe. Maybe I'll give them a Hershey Kiss instead of a candy bar. Like,
or the bad gum that loses flavor before you walk away.
Double bubble. I'll give them double
bubble. Yeah, you got some double bubble.
The only other side that is an exception to me about older kids trick-or-treating is if they're with their younger siblings who are dressed up and they're not, but somebody has to take them around the neighborhood. They're being responsible. You can offer that older sibling some candy because you know they're doing a service. Those are the only two reasons I will give candy to teens.
And that surprises me, because I would consider you one of the nicest people I know, and you usually have like the nice, accepting, rational perspective.
Yeah.
I would think I would be shunning the teenagers and you would be embracing them, because it's one piece of candy. They're not asking for a handful of candy. They're not taking the candy and punching you in the face. They're just coming to the door and still doing something, you know, like Christmas morning, celebrating something that they've done ever since they were a child.
But they still have to make an effort. That's just my only thing. You know, you can't just show up and get candy. I mean, because why don't you do that on a random Tuesday in April?
Right. What do you have in your house?
Well, I heard you say earlier that Jen's had the bowl stocked for 3 months, right?
Oh, my God.
They could have come to your house any day.
We totally have. And we have a nut-free bowl, too, for the kids who have allergies. So, Christy, real quick, tell me about the poll that you put up and what are some of the answers?
So we said, when older kids come to my door trick-or-treating, and then there were three choices. You could say, I feel irritated, or you could choose what you said. It depends on whether they're dressed up or not. And the other choice was, embrace them as openly as I welcome younger children. It was pretty split, but I will say the embrace them as openly as I welcome younger children did get a little bit more than half the vote, about 54%.
But it was close. It depends.
It was super close,
because
then the it depends was 41%, and then only 4% of people feel irritated. So I think that people are softening in general, because I would have thought more people were irritated.
Right.
But yes, I think what you believe and what I believe, it's almost split with the 54-41.
Well, thanks, Christy. This is interesting, because I feel like this will carry on your Facebook and on your blog. Christy, thanks so much.
All right. Bye, Jess. Bye, Christy.
Happy Halloween.